Hi, this is Jerry from Switzerland. Today we have once again a real unboxing this time, so it's still in the packaging and it's a very special thing because it's going to be like an accompanying knife to one of the custom knives I already have from a very talented European knife maker called Michel Timmermans. And he has done this knife for me already. This is his Genesis model. There is a review on this knife on the channel, so you can check that out in the top right corner. And now he has released a new model, or a couple of months or even maybe a year ago, he has released a smaller knife model in his lineup that is called the Treas. I hope I pronounced that correctly. And that's what's inside this box that I received today after some issues with UPS, because there were some issues with delivery, I wasn't home and things like that, but now it finally arrived. And let's tear into the box right there. So very cool maker, very nice design language, and also let's check so I don't reveal any kind of personal information here. Now we gotta cut off the outside packaging. So now we have taken off the outside packaging and opened up the box right here. It was a bit of a hassle here, so I had to kind of cut the video. So we're going to see something similar in terms of specs as we have it here on this absolutely gorgeous Genesis. And you certainly have to notice the very nice kind of dark hand rub satin finish that we have here on this very nice knife. Let's put this to the side and take the very cool custom knife box here out of the packaging. There is another ledger or receipt or something in the box. Let's check that out. There is also the certificate. So let's take a look here. It is the certificate, yes. Nice. He really does great packaging. Nothing else in there. So here you can see the certificate that comes with the knife, with the signature of the maker. You see it is recently made in April, on the 12th April, and it's only the fifth Treas that he has made so far. You see very nice kind of golden lettering there. So really, really cool. This is something that MT Knives or Michel Timmermans does really, really well. And now let's take a look at the knife itself. So this really is the first time I am seeing this for real. I certainly have seen pictures, but let's see how that looks. So very well packaged by the maker. And of course, because you have a very large certificate there, it wouldn't fit in the box itself. And then you have a nice pouch here. And now, after all that unboxing, you'll finally be able to see it. It certainly has a bit of weight to it. The same goes for the Genesis right here, just because there's a lot of zirconium on this build. Amazing work here. Everything's handmade. And here we have the Treas, a very cool companion piece. Let's put that outside of the frame there, so it can kind of focus on the interesting stuff. So here we have the Genesis 2.0, I think, or 2.1. And here we have the Treas. Very cool, compact size, nicely centered, same overall spec. So you see we have the snakeskin carbon fiber, the bronze anodized or gold anodized pivot colors, same zirconium backspacer, dark titanium clip, and the same gorgeous kind of dark hand rub finish on the blade. Really, really cool. And we have a kind of forward finger choil, super ergonomic in the back grip. Let's check that out. In the back grip, it's a bit cramped, I have to say. So if you want to hold it like that to actually use, you're kind of running out of space, but in the kind of forward finger choil right there, this is super ergonomic. Reminds me a bit of a Giant Mouse or Jesper Voxnes design. Absolutely gorgeous blade shape. Liner lock. Great detent. And here you can see how they look together. Certainly a very cool pair. It is a tiny bit smaller than I anticipated. I thought it would be still a very easily a four-finger grippable knife. It still is, but you kind of slide off there at the end with your kind of pinky finger. But it certainly looks absolutely gorgeous. Smaller bolster area, of course, on this one. And he kind of omitted his maker's mark on the newer one. As you have seen here, you have the Michel Timmermans logo, and there you have nothing. So maybe he put something on the inside, or he just lets his design kind of speak for himself. Let's take a look. Maybe we can see something on the inside. I don't see anything there. So maybe that's just a new thing that he does. So even less lettering, even though I kind of liked his logo, I have to say. So there's something I noticed right away. Really love this blade finish and the fit and finish on the bolster and just the overall meeting of the materials is just incredible. As you can see, easy access, maybe a tiny bit of lockstick, but this certainly will break in great as you have seen on the Genesis. Same, very nice and thin cutting edge. I have to check on the blade steel once again. I think it's RWL34, but I have to look that up. You notice that kind of the flat area right here is a bit rougher on the finish than the kind of main bevel. That wasn't the case here on the Genesis model. As you can see, very uniform finish there. And here we have kind of two different kind of grits of finishing. Kind of gives it a bit of a two-tone look. But overall, very cool little knife here from Michel Timmermans. Certainly more of a thicker overall handle and heavier knife than I usually carry or collect. But you also can see the blade stock is very similar on those two. So a very cool kind of pair that we have here from Michel Timmermans. Very well done. And you will see a full review of the Treas model later on once I had some time to carry and use it. And if you like the content, please follow me here as well as on Instagram at 7D_knife_reviews. And there you will see more content on this and all the other knives of my collection. So thanks again for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.